Let's talk about your juicy personal life.
Okay.
I understand that you actually share a bed every night with somebody named Max.
Yeah.
Now, who's Max?
He's
your what?
He's my cat.
He's your cat.
He's my cat.
Okay.
I'm obsessed with him. We have like a very love hate relationship because I go away so often. I come home.
He's angry about that, right? Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
They take a while to warm up after you leave them alone for a while.
They
make you pay for that.
But don't you think that cats sort of are like? Anyway,
I mean, the cool thing is like not with me. That's why we're so cool. He's like aggressively affectionate, and also like when he's not happy, just aggressive.
But has Max ever really kissed you? You know, dogs come up and lick you, and they really make a fuss. But my cat, for 20 years, never gave me a kiss once.
Regis, please stop.
Honestly, like,
When you say aggressively affectionate, it sounds like he really comes up to you and really makes a fuss.
He does. He, like, fights his way into my bed in the morning and wakes me up and drools when he gets really into it or whatever, which is really gross.
Kristen, please stop.
Why are we still talking about your cat?
But I think it's cute. Now, she's going away on a tour.
Are you
going
to bring the cat?
I'm going.
She's gonna try to bring it as many places as she can, right?
We're gonna be shooting in Montreal and New Orleans and Mexico, so Montreal for sure, but probably not. I'm literally gonna take him, hopefully, if I can. I mean, the idea is that he hates to fly, and I would take a train. I would never even do that for myself, but just so I could, like, because he would rip all of his claws out and be crazy by the time he got there and hate me, and so.
Oh, you mean on the plane?
Yeah. I need to figure out how to get him there. I'm like, pay someone to drive him. I don't know.
You know, the more I think about it, the more there should have been a role for Max and Eclipse.
You know, I know a white limousine that would take Max.
Right.
Did you see the cat in the limo? Like, that's right. I'm here.
Let's talk a little bit about the movie now. Yes. Eclipse is like the end of a trilogy about these people, their lives, right?
Yeah.
And have you made up your mind yet about who is going to be what? I mean, who's going to win you in the end? Is it going to be the vampire, the werewolf? Who's it going to be? Or is it Max?
I'm done talking about the cat.
Okay.
I feel really mean. Bella's like, she's always known. That's the whole... It's what I love about Jacob, and this is like reading it as an audience and everyone in the book, like characters, everyone's going like, we all see this, what don't you see, he's amazing, da da da. It takes kissing him, like it takes literally that 2 seconds of complete like vulnerability and like you're completely disarmed to see that like he could really offer her a lot, and you never see that in the entire series because she's so Edward. And I love it because, like, as soon as she goes back to him, it's more about choosing him, and I know that's the whole point, but, like, because she wants him and not because she needs him, like, she's seen the other side, and it's like, I don't, you know, I could actually be with someone else, but I'm choosing this, and it's just less ideal. It's, like, more human. It's, like, older.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, we have a scene where all three of you are there, and the two men of your life are talking about you. Here's Edward and Jacob and Kristen. Take a look.
Doesn't he own a shirt?
I'm good here. You should go.
I'm not gonna be going long.
Don't rush. You need to hunt.
Eclipse in the theater starting tomorrow. Don't miss it.
Kristen, thank you very much for coming.